Good evening and welcome to another proper repair video. This time I'm gonna focus on carbon buildup on piston rings, a well-known issue with M54 engines. This leads to higher oil consumption and loss of compression. To rectify this issue, I will be testing two products. First one is this Toralin anti-carbon piston ring cleaner. It is the closest thing I could find compared to the AC Delco's upper engine cleaner. You spray this directly into the cylinder through the spark plug hole and then wait for about 10 to 20 minutes to dissolve the carbon. The second one is called engine flush, made by Liqui Moly, and is supposed to clean the engine from the inside. As the black cap tells us, it goes directly into the engine oil. After that, you're supposed to idle engine for about 10 minutes and change the oil. I will use oil filter for the flush and then another fresh one. Both filters came with gaskets for the drain plug and the oil filter cap, but you should also replace two other small rings. I'll show you those later. None of these products were sponsored in any way. My oil consumption is about 250 milliliters per 1000 kilometers. Not great, not terrible. Compression, however, can be measured much more accurately. As you see, I've removed the oil cap and the two covers for the nuts. Then remove the nuts, both are 10 mm, and try not to drop them on the floor. To get to the second nut, you need to remove the air duct. It basically just snaps off. Learning from mistakes, I'm using a ratchet and a magnet for the second nut. The cover can now be removed and oil cap put back in its position. Now unhook the coil and unscrew two 10 mm bolts that hold it in place. Take out the coil and put it somewhere safe. Before taking out the spark plug, check out for any debris that could fall into the engine. If all is nice and clean, take out the spark plug using an appropriate 16 mm socket. I will be reusing all spark plugs and coils and put them back into the same cylinders so that the test results are not skewed. And here I am attaching the measuring gauge for the compression. Before the compression test, we need to disable fuel and ignition. On this car, best way is to remove the DME relay. It resides in a protective case under the cabin filter housing. After the housing is removed, there are four screws which need a 5 mm Allen socket for removal. Inside the case, the DME relay is hidden in the back. It is the only one colored blue. Now I am cranking the engine for about 6 revolutions and repeat the process on each cylinder. The compression is not as high as on a new engine, but still within spec and consistent. That is, with the exception of the cylinder 3. Let's also check rough values with INPA program. This basically measures contribution of each cylinder at idle. Lower number means better result, and a dead misfire will have a value of 10. Cylinders are displayed in the firing order, as any bad cylinder will also have impact on the next one in line. To no surprise, values for cylinder 3 are the highest. I will now apply the Toralin product in cylinders 1, 3 and 5. The other three cylinders will serve as a control for this test and as a comparison with the Liqui Moly product. Application is easy, just spray for about 5 seconds into each cylinder and let it sit for 10 to 20 minutes. After those 20 minutes, you're supposed to flush the Toralin out of the cylinders, but those paper towels were dry. In any case, let's check the compression. Cylinder 1 was at the same value as before the test, and as expected, cylinder 2 as well. But the third cylinder... massive improvement! This confirms that the carbon buildup was the cause of the low compression and that the product works. Definitely money well spent. None of the other cylinders, however, showed any improvement. When I compare the figures from INPA, it looks like there is some small improvement as well, but I couldn't say anything conclusive. For the second test, I will add Liqui Moly product to the engine oil. While the can is draining, let's replace the oil filter. Oil filter cap needs a 36 mm socket, and it can be pretty tight. Try not to make a mess when you take the oil filter out. Oil filter is usually set pretty snug, so just tug it firmly and it will come loose. Here are those two O-rings I mentioned earlier. I need to order those separately and will probably replace them off camera. Place a fresh oil filter in and back into the car. I will torque the cap later on the second filter change. Now the car needs to idle for about 10 minutes. I performed another compression test on all cylinders, but there was no difference. Let's take a closer look at the filter. Here I am cutting the filter open and check for any deposits that would be caught in it. I didn't see any. Part of me wishes I would actually have two bad cylinders, then I could really compare the both products. but maybe the engine is clean inside and the engine flush cannot produce any results if there isn't anything to flush. When looking at the rough values in INPA, however, there are some small improvements to see. Values for cylinders 1 and 4 seem to have switched places, but that could be due to being adjacent to each other in the firing order. Nevertheless, with limited data, I'm calling the test of Liqui Moly product inconclusive. Now we need to do the oil change. Let's start with the filter, and this time I'm changing the O-ring on the filter cap. Make sure you lubricate it with oil and that it sits properly in the groove. To install the new filter, you should hear a click when it's in position. Screw it back in place, either hand tight or to 25 Nm if using a torque wrench. Now remove the belly pan. There are 3 Phillips screws on each side and 2 more in the back. The belly pan will fall down of its own, just slide it out of the way. Now secure the wheels, check up the car, place jack stands, lower the car and make a use of that spare wheel. Now give the car a good shake to make sure that it's stable. Now let's dive underneath the car. And here is the oil drain plug. Place an oil canister under the car. If you're using a similar one to mine, make sure you open up both caps so that the air can escape while oil drains. Drain plug responds to a 17mm socket. Once you get it loose, you can move it by hand, just be prepared for some hot oil. While the oil is draining, which can take some time, I'm gonna clean the plug a bit. I'm just using some brake cleaner and paper towels. And at the end, of course, we place a new gasket on it. You can also clean the area around the frets, but don't spray brake cleaner directly onto them, rather spray it on the paper towel. Or perhaps use a rag of some sort, since paper towels tear easily. Torque spec on the plug is 25 Nm. Oil for this engine should have a specification of BMW Long Life 01 or Long Life 04. This GTX oil is semi-synthetic and not much cheaper than the BMW oil, so this is the one I will use. Despite BMW recommending a straw, this one is actually made by Shell. After you've double-checked that the drain plug is back in its place, it's time for the most satisfying part of this job, filling the engine with some fresh oil. As you see, this canister doesn't have a protective foil at the top. If yours has it, be sure not to punch it through with your thumb. A small part of the foil could end up in your engine, so be sure to carefully and fully remove it. But in my case, just pour the oil in. The engine takes 6.5 liters of oil, so I'm gonna pour in 6 canisters and then check the level. Let's take out the dipstick, and we're just at the minimum. I'm gonna add another half of canister and then check later again on a warm engine. Whatever is left, stow it somewhere in the car. My final thoughts on both products. Toralin's Anticarbon spray is definitely an excellent product and did help in my case. Liqui Moly's engine flush certainly didn't cause any harm, but there was no significant improvement either. That being said, I would try it again. Maybe it wasn't meant to improve anything on this engine, or the Toralin already fixed that.